skates or sharpen the sticks or tape. The ice is ready to go. James and Ray ready to bring it all. Well, the moment of truth is almost upon us here. They are about to drop the puck. The Legends start with possession as we are now underway. Looks to pass it to Crossman. With the bank pass. And he gets just enough of it to keep it out for the back of the net.
Positioning's perfect. He gets into the butterfly and makes the save.
Lots of time left in this period. Still looking for our first goal. Gatineau's got it in the offensive zone.
Whoa!
He scores! And this place got quiet quick.
Well, that's the way you want to start on the road. You talk about getting early momentum. Nothing better than that. We talk about face-offs a lot, and I'm not so sure that the percentages really matter sometimes. It's where you win them. Here's an offensive zone win that leads directly to this goal.
Well, that's one way to win the draw as he skates away with the puck after the two centers were tied up. And he was slowed up. Hooking looks to be the call as the official's arm goes up in the air. And now he moves it to Crossman. And the officials will pass the sentence here.
You can actually gain a little momentum here if the penalty killers do the job. Down a goal, if they kill this, you're going to have some jump.
Andrioff's looking to use his zone ability to generate some scoring here, guys. The power play is a great opportunity for him to use his skills to his team's advantage.
And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Edmonton's going to be able to kill a few seconds off now with the puck. The Legends will play it from the corner. Driving right to the front! And that somehow stayed out of the net. Nice save from point-blank range. And sends it just out of reach. And we'll reset things after that icing.
Oh, he ripped that right after the whistle.
What's he thinking? Kid's done everything here except pull the other guy's gloves off.
Bissonnette's ready to take the draw here on this power play. Gatineau's got it in the defensive zone.
It's almost like he dug in a little deeper there after the icing to win that draw.
And he'll take a moment to regroup back at center. Thunder is hit.
Well, that's inevitable. He had his head down, got hit so hard he dropped his stick. Now he's got to go pick it up before he can join the play again.
That's why coaches say keep your head up, right?
Well, that's one of the reasons.
They got a pair on a 2-on-1. Edmonton's got the puck in their own end. Can't connect on the pass. Gatineau's got a hold of the puck. Sends a pass over. Andreoff's got it against the boards. Oh, and he just gets... He scores!
In close, one of the game's better shooters. You cannot leave him alone. He does not miss there. He doesn't need too many chances from in here. You get this tight to the net with a shot that accurate, you're going to score a lot of goals.
Well, guys, as we just saw in that play, he was able to use his close-quarter zone ability to shoot right and tight and get it past the goalie.
Edmonton's got a hold of the puck off the draw. And the puck hops out of the
offensive
zone. He's forced to regroup. Slides the puck over. From behind the net. Broken up by Travis. The Legends will play it in their own end. Grabs control of it at the point. On the doorstep. Can't connect. Moved out in front. Gatineau's grabbed a hold of the puck. Picked off in the offensive end. Andreoff's got the puck. Here's a chance right in the slot. Oh, what a stop. Into the corner now. Gatineau's got a hold of it against the wall. And it's a quick pass to Crossman. Intercepted the pass.
Edmonton's stick position is exemplary tonight. Teams can look at this on video and say that's how you defend the middle of the ice.
Oh, what a stop on the play. Gets all of it with the paddle. Well past the midway mark of this period. Gatineau's really controlled the pace of play these last few minutes, leading by two. Bissonnette's won the faceoff. And now he tries to get it across to Kidd. Puck grab by Crossman. Takes a shot, and there's the save. Jabs the puck away. Edmonton's got a hold of the puck now. Oh, hello! What a collision!
Yeah, that's not a collision. That's one player delivering a solid body check to another. He's known for this. If you have your head down for just a second, look out.
Moves it quickly over to Andreev. And that's blocked. Edmonton's got the puck along the wall. There's the whistle icing the call. Face-off set to resume. And sneaks in and grabs possession. Across the line from center. Trying to engage a little physicality here. Gatineau's on the attack. And things starting to ramp up a little bit now on the ice with that play. Whoa! He scores! That's how you do it! Leadership to a T! The captain capitalizes!
That goal is the byproduct of his puck-on-a-string superstar ability, guys. His stick handling opened up some space, and he puts one up on the board.
From the neutral zone now. Edmonton's got the puck against the half wall. That pass doesn't go. Gatineau's ready to go on the attack. Here's a pass down low. Travis moves the puck. Takes the feed. Gatineau's looking to break out of their own end. Trying to clear, and they get it out. Final minute approaching here in this opening frame. Takes a shot. That goes off a twig. Gatineau's got the puck in the defensive end. Reads it perfectly and comes up with the takeaway. And they cough it up in the neutral zone. He scores!
Now they can go into this intermission, James. They got to feel great about themselves. They tally so late in this period. No way sometimes for the goalie to catch up to the pass. It's too quick. It's one timed into the net.
Puck is dropped and play resumes. And with that, the first period is in the books. Both teams with a chance at a refresh. We'll get a clean sheet of ice and come back with period number two.
Guys, take a look at this banner displayed here. This club worked so hard last season, and you know, the hard work continues this season as well. They're a great club. They've got a lot of heart, and they work hard. They're really going to be fun to watch this season.
Aaron pass, and they can't connect. Play whistle dead. Penalty coming up.
This is always a fine line penalty. You're allowed a little interference, just not that much.
The Legends get their man advantage unit out there for the first time tonight.
First chance of the night for the power play. The guys are pretty excited to get out there and see if they can get on the board.
Gets it out of his own end. Edmonton's gained possession. Takes the feed in the middle of the neutral zone. Oh, and somehow he gets a sliver of it and keeps him at bay.
Days had a good seat for most of this offensive explosion. They're winning by a pile, and he hasn't had much to do.
Quick feed to Travis. And that's poked away by Crossman. Here's the clearing attempt. And a nice job by the Killers on that one.
Yeah, now they can get a change, get some fresh players on the ice.
That goes wide.
He said that time is almost done.
The Legends come up empty-handed on the power play. We're back to even strength here.
The only positive for the power play there is they didn't have to skate up and down the ice. They didn't generate anything. They had it in the zone, but really nothing very good about it.
Broken up with the stick in the defensive end.
Andreyev's able to take that quick pass. He's already got a couple of goals. He's looking for a third.
Going after that loose puck by any means necessary. Edmonton's got it in their own zone. Dumps it into the other end. Looks like we got a penalty coming up here. And here's a shot. Oh, and that stays out with the toe save. Whistle blows, stopping the play.
Just trying to slow your opponent down a little bit. Oftentimes you get too much of them and you end up taking an interference penalty.
Power play unit going back to work.
Power plays go up and down. That's just the way they are. But when you haven't been successful, you've got to reload, refocus, and get to work on that next one.
Tries to get this man advantage going from their own end now. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. The Legends gain possession. Through the neutral zone now, picking up steam. Almost lost the puck, but hangs on here as play continues. And couldn't find the intended receiver on that one. And they send it down the ice. Looking to break out here on the power play. Edmonton's got the puck against the wall. Travis moves the puck to the corner. Gatineau's got the puck shorthanded. And they clear that puck. The Legends run out of time on the man advantage. Both sides back to even strength.
And nobody's going to be very happy about that one, James. No real chances generated. No momentum game. Just a couple of minutes roll off the clock.
And tries to make a diagonal pass to Andreyev. Edmonton's got control of it now from their own end. Here's a chance. 3-on-1. Oh, he'd like to have that one back as it goes off the side.
Hit the net. No chance to score if you don't get the puck on target.
He scores! The captain leading by example!
Man, he dropped the shoulder and made the deke. The goalie bit hard, and there's all kinds of room to put it in low in the net.
Edmonton's back to center ice. What's the message here? Because there's still a long way to go.
I don't think anybody looks too far ahead. You got one goal. Try and get another. Try and get yourself within shouting distance. Oh, that's going to be a penalty. They're going to have to call that.
We got a whistle. Penalty coming up.
The coach just looks skyward as his team's taken its third penalty of this period.
Power play unit puts their hard hats on as they go back to work. Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. Play is whistled dead as the puck goes up and over. Edmonton's got a 5-on-3 and lots of time on their side.
Oh, the offensive players are licking their chops here. This is a long 5-on-3. The potential to do damage is sitting right in front of them.
And manages to clear the zone. The Legends have it now. Edmonton's on the attack. Tees him up and a great save.
He keeps moving in the offensive zone, trying to set himself up for the one-timer. This one's in his wheelhouse, and he hammers it. But the goalie beats him with the stop.
Bank pass off the boards. He clearly doesn't like that.
Andreoff's turning this challenge down. That's not part of his game.
Edmonton's got the puck now. Chance right in front. Scores! That's how you draw up with the extra attacker.
Well, you've got the extra man, so you want to move the puck more quickly. You want to retrieve it with greater numbers. They do it all well, and they're on the board. This has to be frustrating. He's in the right spot. He makes the save. Well, at least most of it. The rest of it's in the net.
While the centers are jammed up, nice job by the winger to steal the puck.
Bissonnette's up and ready to join the play.
Puck cleared from the defensive end. Power play has expired. He looks deep to Kidd. And that's broken up with a stick in front. And he uses his reach to disrupt the play. And they won't connect on that one. Read that perfectly with the poke check. The Olympique has played along the wing. There's the whistle. We've got an offside. In the final moments of this period, the Legends are still trailing by two. Good read by the winger as the two centers tie up. Some good stick work to force that turnover. Great positioning in the defensive end. Off target. And the puck leaves the zone. Gadneau's gained possession. Edmonton's got the puck. Enters the offensive zone from the left. Day's going to cover it up and get a whistle.
Even with the traffic starting to close in, he had to grab that when he did.
Both teams are set. They're ready to drop the puck. Play resumes as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. And that's broken up in the defensive zone by Kidd. Couldn't connect on that pass. Tries to feed it over to Travis. Great read with the stick. And he slides it quickly to Crossman. He might have a step here. Some solid defensive work in the road end with the poke check. And there we go. Icing is the call. Edmonton's won the faceoff. And that's blocked away. And there's the horn. Two down. One more to go. Both teams will get a chance to catch their breath and get ready for a big third period next. They're ready to drop the puck on period number three. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Let's do this. Barring extra time, the final frame of this one. Here we go. Third period is underway. Ray Ferraro is back down at ice level. Ray, 40 minutes played so far. What's been your assessment of this tilt?
Edmonton's had such a meager total of shots on goal. Predictably, they haven't scored. They've got to get more pucks to the net.
Oh, a whole lot of truculence with that.
That hit was delivered with intent. That's not to rub somebody out of the play. That's to send a message.
The Olympique has gained control of the puck. Looks to get the puck over to Bissonnette. Pushes it across to Kidd. And they'll go the other way with it. Keeps control of the puck after taking a little knock. Gets it back. Moves the puck along the half wall. And now it's over to Crosman. And he rings the post!
Gatineau still in the same spot. That's a good scoring chance where the puck hits the pipe and stays out.
Oh, misses the net. You don't see that too often right there.
Not from him. I mean, he's usually pretty accurate. It's a low percentage shot to score. He doesn't miss the net very often from that distance, but this time he does.
Still lots of time left here in this frame. 4-2 is the score. Bissonnette's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone.
Now you got a chance to make something against a tired team. Get it on goal, man.
Oh.
That chance is not going to come along very often.
Picked up along the boards by Crosman. Moves it over to Andre.
Hello there.
Oh, he laid a solid hit on him there. He was waiting for him and laid the shoulder right in.
Scores! That's three!
I had 9 of these, James. It is such a cool thing to score 3. You feel so good about yourself.
Gatineau's added to their lead here in this third period. It's been nonstop.
I like how they've scored and then gone after the next one, James. They've had their foot down on the gas pedal the whole night.
And no luck on that pass attempt. Crossman's lugging the puck. Kidd swooping in on the attack. And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. Andreas been dropped up, and we got a penalty coming up here. Here comes the call from the official.
It goes from disappointment to embarrassment now. I mean, there is nothing gone right for them tonight.
The Olympique has once again sent out their power play unit.
Hey, it doesn't really matter what the power play's done before you. You got to have a short memory. What you have now is a power play right in front of you. Make sure you're focused in on what you're trying to accomplish.
And the puck leaves the zone. Trying to get something going here with this man advantage as they start from their own end. Right in front of the official's eyes, and the hand is in the air. And let's see what the definitive call is on the ice.
Lots of barking back and forth here on the bench as the players are starting to get frustrated with the number of penalties they're taking.
Puck set to drop. We've got some 4-on-4 coming up.
Once you get the puck on 4-on-4, just don't give it up. You've got space. Use it.
Gets it over to Travis. Couldn't make that one happen. And that's picked off in front. Can't get it to go. The Legends gain control of the puck against the wall. Strong defensive effort. Gains the zone through the middle. Gatineau's got it along the wall. And that's picked off in the defensive end. And as the penalty expires, they'll go to work now on the man advantage. Gatineau's got it in their own zone. And they get the puck out. Time running out with this man advantage. Here we go. Both teams back to even strength. Really nice effort by the penalty-killing unit on that one.
Pretty hard to have a more low-intensity power play than that. They really didn't generate a thing, and when you don't generate much, you're sure not going to score.
Taken by Crossman. Edmonton's got the puck. Gatineau's got the puck inside the defensive zone.
Edmonton's just trying to get to the end of the game here. I've played in games like this, and there was...
It's in the back of the net, but it's not going to count as the whistle goes before the puck went in.
Bissonnette's out there on this power play, and you know he'll be looking to use his zone ability to help the team score here, guys. Let's see how things play out.
And the puck clears the zone. Grabs the puck and moves on out here with this man advantage. Can't find his man. Puck hops onto the bench, and we got a stoppage in play. Bissonnette's ready for the draw as we get set to resume this power play.
And with the two centers tangled up, the winger skates away with it. Andreyev's taking it from his own end. Quick pass to Crossman. Through the neutral zone, moving the puck along the side. From their own end, trying to kickstart this power play. Gatineau's moving it along the wing. All alone! And I'm not quite sure what the hope was on that.
James, you said it. Look at that. Here we go. We got a penalty coming up right here. I don't believe the coaches are going to be too worried about this. They didn't score on the power play, but I think it's most important that they didn't give anything up.
Well, that'll get a response.
Teal's ready to go. Apparently, the other guy doesn't want anything to do with him. There's going to be a penalty on this play here, James.
Along the half wall with the puck. Delayed penalty coming up here. The Olympics have it now. Moves the puck across to Kidd. Passes it over to Crossman. Tosses it to Andreyev. Breakaway! And it kind of falls apart here at the end.
James, I'm going to assume he had a different idea about how that was going to finish up.
And now he passes up to Andreyev. There's the whistle, and here's the call.
We'll get these penalties when we get back to play, but right now the rink announcer's got a throat lozenge in. He's going to have to do a lot of talking.
Kidd's team has the advantage here with the power play, and it's an opportunity for him to use his zone ability and maybe even help the team light the lamp.
Nice job tying up his opponent. Gatineau's got the puck against the boards. Moves behind the net. Here's a short pass to Bissonnette. Broken up with the stick in the defensive end. Dished on over to Andreyev. Great forecheck by Travis. Bissonnette's got the puck in his own zone. He's all alone with the goaltender. Boss has made his way to the bench and the extra attacker's on the ice. Picked up along the wall by Crossman. And it is all over with this one. Well, fans were certainly treated to a performance tonight. Very one-sided, though.
Yeah, unless you were a fan of that team that never touched the puck or never scored enough goals. I mean, that couldn't have been any fun.
No. James Sabolski along with Ray Ferraro. We're ready to go. I know you're ready to go. Let's drop the puck. Looking forward to this one tonight. The Olympiques take possession here on the opening draw, and we are underway. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. Couldn't complete the pass. And that pass can't connect. Takes the pass. Moves it over to Callahan. They go on the attack through center. Great poke check on the reach. Grabbed along the boards by Kidd. The Wildcats scoop it up along the boards. Can't connect on the pass. Moncton's looking to break out. Takes the puck at the point. From off the boards, takes the feed inside the zone. We got a stoppage as the puck sails over the glass. We're still in the early stages of this period. Still scoreless in this one. Bissonnette's won a big draw on their own end. And now he angles it across to Andreoff. And it's poked away in the neutral zone. Nice heads-up play there. And we'll get a breather here with offside the call. Swoops in off the wing to grab the puck after the centerman tied him up. Blocked in traffic. The Wildcats have it against the wall. Moves it to Kidd. That pass doesn't go. Passes on over to Bissonnette. Great reach with the poke check. Moves the puck. Errant pass and they can't connect. Moves it quickly over to Bissonnette. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Slides the puck to Kidd. Good heads-up play in the defensive zone. Quick feed to Kidd. The Olympiques gain possession along the wall. Into the corner. From the boards, he takes that pass. That opportunity is rejected. There's the whistle as the goalie hangs on. Still lots of time left in the period. We're still scoreless. Gatineau's got it in the offensive zone. Scores!
The offensive zone faceoff gives them the jump on puck possession. Shortly thereafter, it's in the net. That faceoff is the key, though.
And play resumes as the puck is dropped. Picked off by Huberdeau. Takes the feed. And skilled use of the stick to poke the puck away. Takes the feed. And the puck leaves the zone going back to center ice. Right up the gut, here they go. Grips it and rips it. Oh, he'll feel that one later on, but what a block. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Gatineau's got possession of the puck. And no!
That's a race to the post. The goalie gets there first. They read the play as well as the players, and that's an excellent stop.
And they won't connect on that one. Pass across to Callahan. Intercepted.
Gatineau's team defense is something to watch tonight. I love the way that they've just shut this game down.
Oh, getting a little cheeky there.
Bissonnette's looking around for somebody to fight. He's going to have to go and fill the dance card somewhere else.
Past the halfway mark of this period, Gatineau's ahead 1-0. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Denies that opportunity.
Slides across in the butterfly to make the save, but you still have to be agile even though you're covering the bottom of the net.
And no luck on that pass attempt. The Wildcats move to the offensive zone. There's another for the hit parade. Quick pass to Andreoff. Shot! He scores!
It's good to be greedy. You get one, you chase that next one. Really put your foot down on the opponent.
So nice, they snipe twice.
Good position to get towards the net where you can deflect the puck. So as we see on the replay, that's excellent positioning and good eye hand to deflect the puck past the goalie.
Gatineau's won the draw and they take possession here in the open ice. Puck hops out of the offensive zone. They'll be forced to do it over from center. And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. Slides the puck ahead to Kidd. Penalty coming up as the play's blown dead. Bissonnette's getting two for tripping. A chance to capitalize here on the power play.
Power play and penalty kill go a long way to determining what your team's going to be like. This is the power play's first chance. We'll see if they can get on the board.
Pass back to the point. Right in front! And they can't convert on the play! Here's a chance! Turns it aside with the glove. Kids at the faceoff dot, ready to win this draw on the man advantage. They take possession as he locks them up off the faceoff. Trying to get out of the defensive end. And it's a small victory for the PK unit here.
Well, that's their job. Get it down the ice, get off the ice, get some new people out there.
From the point, they take control of it. Centering pass! And that one's blocked! Sends it in on the attack. Moves it on over to Huberdeau.
Bissonnette's ready to join the play.
And the power play comes up empty. Both teams back to even strength.
Oh, when the puck moves and the feet don't, this is what you get. You had lots of zone time, but no real dangerous chances on that power play.
Receives the pass. And with the buzzer, that puts a bow on the first 20 minutes of play. We've got lots more still to come. Second period action next, right here. Teams with a chance to recharge and refresh, and this second period about set to get underway. Center's jammed up and the winger grabs the puck. Gatineau's got a hold of it against the wall. Here's a short pass to Callahan. Good defensive stop with the poke check. Way too much congestion blocks that. Puck scooped up by Kidd. We got a whistle, offside to call. Lots of time left in this period. 2-0 is where we sit. Locks them up on the draw as they take possession. That's just a great heads-up read at center ice. Moves the puck down low. Nice pass. Quick pass to Bissonnette. Long reach breaks up the momentum. Takes the pass from the left wing. Fires it into the offensive zone. Scores! Took a weird bounce off a skate and passed the goaltender.
It's hard enough to be the goalie when you have to stop the shot. This thing's like a rubber ball and bouncing all over the place and somehow ends up behind the goalie. That's a tough break for him.
Officials are in position, and both teams are getting ready as they get set for another faceoff here. Moves the puck over to Bissonnette. Quick shot! Stopped by the goaltender. In front of the net, the goaltender covers up for a whistle on the play. Gadnos won the draw. Too much congestion blocks the shot. Denies him on the play.
Usually he gets into close quarters, James. It's money. Not this time. The goalie beats him with the stop.
And he makes a save on that play.
No time to take a breath. He made that first stop, and then the puck turns around on him again.
Now into the offensive zone from the right side. Too many bodies in the way. Taken along the wall by Huberdeau. And a huge stop by the goaltender at point-blank range.
Days
scores! The captain delivers!
I never had much of a one-timer. That one right there is a bullet. He takes the pass, times it well, and hammers it home.
More than half the period left to play. Gadnos now up by four. Play is thrown dead with the offside. And they take possession. Nice job tangling him up on the draw. And gets it in deep in the opposite corner. Feeds it on over to Kidd. Moves it to Bissonnette. That's some smart heads-up defensive play by Huberdeau. Gains the zone through center. Play whistle dead, offside the call. Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession so key in today's game. Moncton's won it. Sends it deep inside the offensive zone. Gadnos got a hold of the puck. Andreyev's got it in the offensive zone. Handles the puck. Can't get it to go. And now it's grabbed by Kidd. Errant pass and the play's broken up. Great heads up play with the stick by Huberdeau. Moves it quickly over to Callahan. Gadnos got control of it now from their own end. Good read with the stick to break that up. Quick feed to Kidd. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. And called for the offside. We'll get a face-off. More than half the frame has been played here. Gadnos been the better team, and the scoreboard reflects it. They lead it 4-0. Puck is dropped, and we are back underway. And now he moves it to Kidd. Broken up with the stick in the defensive zone. Sends the pass over. Quick pass to Kidd. And that slides right out to center ice. Stoppage in play, offside the call. Bissonnette's won the draw here in the neutral zone. Kidd's got it in the defensive end. Couldn't complete the pass. Sends a pass over. And they cough it up in the neutral zone. The Wildcats have a hold of it in the defensive zone. Here's a short pass to Kidd. And that pass can't connect. Gets a hold of the puck here in his own end. Moncton's got it in the neutral zone. The Wildcats looking against the half wall. And that's picked off. And they get the puck out of the defensive end. And they can't connect. And now he tries to get it across to Callahan. And that's knocked away in the defensive end by Crossman. Nice feed from the left side up the middle. Andreyev's got it along the wing. Looks to set up at the point now. Comes up with the stop. There's the whistle as things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck.
Getting into the later stages of this period. It's 4-0. This has been a one-sided affair right from the get-go. Tries to get it over to Callahan. And he regains control of the puck. Forces the turnover in the defensive zone. Look at the side. He scores!
In close, one of the game's better shooters. You cannot leave him alone. He does not miss there. Great example here of close-quarter zone ability, James. In tight, you have to still deliver that puck accurately. It's done to perfection.
Well, guys, as we just saw in that play, he was able to use his close-quarter zone ability to shoot right in tight and get it past the goalie.
And the puck departs the zone. There's the buzzer bringing the second period to an end. Been a great night of hockey here on EA Sports. We've got a third period just around the corner. In the books. Big third period coming up for both teams, and we're ready to go. It's been a total mismatch here as we get underway for the third. Let's see if anything changes. And we'll get a face-off after the offside call.
Crossman's effective because he distributes the puck so cleanly, guys. His tape-to-tape zone ability is what helps him set up his teammates for success.
Kids won the draw here in the open ice. A rocket from the point. Oh, it serves up a little too sweet with that save. Moncton's got control of it now here in the offensive end. Kind of lost control for a second there, but regains possession. Moves it to Kidd. Fails to find the open man. Gagnon's gained possession along the boards. Trying to get it out of their own end. Well, that went sideways, but they still maintain possession. Off the crossbar! And we'll get a reset after the puck goes up and out of play. Lots of time left in this period. Gatineau's put on a smothering offensive performance. They lead it 5-0. Good job tangling up his opponent here. Oh, textbook quick check to turn that over. Feeds it over to Huberdeau. Can't connect on the pass. Crossman stick handling in his own zone. He grabs the puck here at the point. Let's it go! And that one's stopped.
Once he drops into that butterfly, he's pretty confident. He's got most of the net covered. He slides across to make the save.
Nearing the midway mark of the period. Gatineau's got a 5-0 lead. That's right, 5-0 is where we sit. Well, that's one way to win the draw as he skates away with the puck after the two centers were tied up. And they get the puck out of the danger zone. Nice job to escape the zone. Now he takes it over the line. Dumps it into the O-zone. Great pressure on the offensive end by Huberdeau. Moncton's got the puck along the wall. Tosses it on to Andreoff. Here he is, shot right in front. The Olympique has taken along the wall. The Wildcats are on the attack. Slides it across. That pass doesn't go. Pokes it away to keep the pressure on. Gatineau's got a hold of the puck now. Exploring options here inside the defensive zone. From center they get into the attacking area. Looking to make something happen along the boards. And that's a great heads up in the defensive zone to force the turnover. Takes control of the puck.
Gatineau's defense has been exceptional. They've defended well, kept the front of the net clean, and whenever there's a rebound, they get it out of there fast.
Moved up ahead after a nice pass from the right wing. There's the whistle. Offside is the call. Here in the back half of this period, a quick look at the scoreboard. It's too much to not enough. 5-0. Slides in off the wing after the centerman tied him up. Moncton's got the puck in their own end. And play continues here. Slides the puck across to Crossman. Oh, great play to use the wall handling the pass. Slides the puck over.
Bissonnette's 4 points is just part of this onslaught. I mean, they are blowing the other guys out of the rink. Oh, look at that. Here we go. We got a penalty coming up right here.
Couldn't connect, although not exactly an ideal pass to begin with. Moves it quickly over to Kidd. Let's see what the officials are calling.
I think this is long out of hand here, but unfortunately they're not going to call it. They still have to finish the game.
Man advantage unit is set.
Power plays go up and down. That's just the way they are. But when you haven't been successful, you've got to reload, refocus, and get to work on that next one.
Quick feed to Huberdeau. Poked away in the neutral zone. Right up the gut into the attacking zone. Sends the pass down low. And that's intercepted in the defensive end. Drives to the paint.
Whoa.
Scores! Had about as much room as a phone. I don't even know if they make those anymore, but what a goal!
I don't think they do, James, but he's in close quarters. He has no room really to maneuver, but he does not miss very often from there. That's a great shot.
He's so good when he gets near the net like that, guys. That's his close quarter zone ability, and he made a great shot to get one past the goaltender.
Quick pass to Kidd. The Wildcats will play it from the defensive zone. Here's a short pass to Kidd. Gatineau's got possession at center. Takes the pass. Puts it on net. That's not going to fool him. Kidd's got a hold of the puck behind the net. Takes the feed. Less than a minute to go now here in regulation. Moves it to Bissonnette. Here's a shot. Oh, brings it off the outside of the iron. Thought he had the corner, but clearly not.
The Olympiques have a big, comfortable lead here. They're way up and in no danger in this game, but you know the shooter would want that one.
Gatineau's got the puck behind the net. Moncton's got it behind the net. Oh, he'd like to have that pass back. Moves it quickly over to Callahan. Feeds it down low. Excellent stick work on the play. And that's a great defensive heads up to force the turnover. Into the corner of the attacking area. Too much traffic in the lane. Gatineau's got the puck. Looking for space inside the D zone. There's the final horn, and this one's in the books.
Well, they threw down the challenge, and guess they were ready for it.
Well, I think they picked their opponent rather strategically here, James. It's not like they went after the big hitter.
Look at that. Shots fired.
Hey everyone, Carlin here, and just a tip for all you club owners out there. A good goal song is just as important as a good goal. Make sure your club has the right jam to celebrate those pucks hitting the back of the net and get your squad fired up. Carlin here. Just a reminder to check out the challenge cards to earn rewards that are only available for a limited time. Do you think you can fulfill the challenges? Go take a look before hitting the ice. Welcome back to the world of Chell.
A gorgeous night. Fans are amped up. I am too. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro, ready for all the action. Both teams lined up in the middle. We are ready to get things underway. There's been a healthy buzz for this one. Now it's time to see if it lives up to the hype. Moves it around along the half wall. And here comes the pushback.
Kidney's ready to go. Apparently the other guy doesn't want anything to do with him.
Takes control of the puck. Big time stop.
Day's made a great save here. He flashes just enough of the body to make the stop on a really great scoring chance.
And they get that puck down the ice. Shuts him down.
They're working really hard these days to make sure when they stop the puck, it doesn't stay in front of them. If they can't stop it and catch it, they want that puck in the corner.
Here's a shot. And she misses. Ferraro, I know what she's going to hear when she gets to the bench based on our conversations.
The coach is going to be all over her to hit the net, but she knows that. She's trying to hit the net. She's just a little too fine. That puck's got to be in the middle of the net to have a chance.
Still early on in this frame, James and Ray with you. So glad you could join us. We've still got zeros on the board. Puck picked up by Crossman. Slides it across to Andreoff. Still keeps a hold of the puck.
It's only a game.
Oh,
why you have to be
collision mad? Lined up in the railroad tracks. And serves up a little knock on the play. Scoops up the puck here. And he slides it quickly to Bissonnette. And that pass is redirected. Moves the puck. The Olympique take possession here in the open ice. Oh, that'll make the highlight reel, Ray.
Sometimes there's nowhere to go when you run into a dead end.
Bissonnette's got that wrist shot that he likes to deliver from far out, guys. His heat-seeker zone ability means he can put a lot of power behind a shot and still be accurate from afar. You gotta look to him to put pucks on net.
Poked away by Gates. Up to the challenge as he gets his pad on it. Wow, completely ignored the whistle there.
Kid's done everything here except pull the other guy's gloves off.
Inching closer to the midway mark of the period. Still looking for our first goal. Sneaks away with the puck after he was tangled up on the draw. Answered the call there.
I almost can't believe he didn't score from there. I'd bet on him from that close.
Takes a shot. Gets a piece of it to keep it out. Gatineau's got the puck in the defensive end. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Bissonnette. Scooped up along the wall by Crossman. Takes the feed. Pokes the puck away. Oceanics ready to go on the attack. Here's the chance to set up now. Answered the call on that play.
They work the puck into a scoring spot. Get a pretty good chance on goal. They just can't find a way to finish it off.
Slides the puck down low. Picked up along the boards by Ayers. Back to the point it goes. Crossman's caught with the hook and the officials saw it. The Olympique has moved the puck in the defensive zone. Now a quick pass to Andreoff. Time for the official to pass down his sentence.
I think he knew right away, James. He made that play with his stick, put the hook around his waist, and he knows he's going to the box.
And their first chance to use the man advantage.
Oh, I love playing on the power play. It's my favorite thing I did. So here you are in a scoreless game. These guys can't get on the ice fast enough for their first opportunity.
And that's a solid clearing attempt on the play. Nice zone entry from the middle. Receives the pass. And the lane's clogged up blocking that. Kiss is ready for the face-off as they'll continue to kill off this penalty. Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. And a stick breaks that up. Takes the puck as the clock ticks down on the penalty kill. Big time stop there.
He swallows that puck up as he slides across in the butterfly to make the save.
Nice pass. Things starting to get a little physical out there. Deflected away. Nice defensive use of the stick there. And they send it down the ice. One last rush here on this power play. And the man advantage unit comes up empty-handed. We keep things deadlocked with both teams back at even strength.
These are the power plays that drive coaches crazy. They didn't really generate anything. They didn't force the penalty killers at all. Kind of a waste of time.
Play is called for offside. Here in the late going of the frame, still scoreless in this one. Long Island's got a hold of the puck off the draw. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. Gatineau's got it in their own zone. Handles the puck. Here's a chance. Oh, gets a little piece of it. And keeps it out of the net. Long Island's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Offside the call. We'll get a face-off coming up. Center's gliding up to the face-off dots here. While the centers are jammed up, nice job by the winger to steal the puck. Sent into the offensive zone. The Olympiques have it against the wall. Here's a chance right in front. Quick feed to Bissonnette. Gatineau's got the puck in their own end with time winding down. Up the neutral zone now. Errant pass and they can't connect. There's the buzzer, 20 minutes in the books, second period just around the corner. And the official seems about ready to drop the puck on period number two. Both teams still feeling each other out after a scoreless 20. Let's see if that changes here in period number two. Well, we've got over 20 minutes played thus far. Ray, how have you seen things?
Gatineau's got to look up at that clock and be pretty fortunate that this game is scoreless. They gave the puck away way too much in that first period.
Crossman's taking it from his own end. Textbook poke check by Kiss. Picked up along the wall by Crossman. Passes it to Andreoff. Great defensive effort with the stick. With possession along the wall. The Olympiques gain possession in their own end. Sends it across. Long Island's got a hold of it along the wall. On the attack along the boards. Gatineau's gained possession. And the puck clears the zone. Breaking through center, they go on the attack. Sends it in deep. Quick pass to Crossman. Andreoff's moving it ahead. Oh, what a stop!
As he slides in the butterfly, he's in great shape to make this save.
Oceanic's got the puck along the wall. Can't catch up to the pass. Gatineau's got it from behind the net. Moving into the attacking zone. That's moved up ahead. Oh, no luck as it goes off the outside of the post.
What a shot. I mean, really good play, but it hits the post, and like everything else in this game, it stays out of the net.
Along the right wing, they enter the attacking area. And a great save! Timmins makes the save and hangs on for a stoppage of play. We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. The game is still scoreless. And a solid job tying up his opponent. Slapped away by the blocker. Here's a short pass to Andreev with the stop. Long Island's got possession of the puck. Puck grabbed by Kidd. And there's another stop.
Doesn't lose his focus as he makes a couple of quick ones in a row.
Pucks it away here in the neutral zone. We've got icing on the play. Faceoff coming up. More than half the period has gone by. Hope you're enjoying this one. Still no score in this one. Gatineau's got possession here in their own end.
You can wheel the breakout now once you win that draw.
Can't complete the pass as it goes off a stick. Here's a shot. Blocked in front. Moves it to Bissonnette. And they won't connect on that one. Gives up the body in order to block the shot. A chance in front. Oh, and it stays out with the toe save. He was locked in there.
Yeah, I hated when I miss chances like this, James. You don't get many that are this quality. You want to put them away because you don't know when the next one's going to come.
Long Island's got a hold of it against the wall. Grabs the puck. Trying to clear the puck. Grabs control of it at the point. Through the middle of the ice, they enter the attacking zone. Getting a little too physical to maintain possession. Poked away in the offensive end. Stopped by the goaltender. Directs it on over to Kidd. Odd man rush. Stopped by the goaltender.
Really good work. I like this chance here as they get the puck into a scoring spot.
He scores!
Man, you haven't had a chance to use that tonight. Finally! Somebody scores a goal and we have a lead.
Hopefully I didn't boot that one.
Man, it looks like a bus depot in front of the net. You know it's a tough one when you can't see the goalie. That means he can't see the puck.
His close quarter superstar ability is that accuracy from being near the net, and he did not miss on that chance, guys. What a great shot.
Scores! That's two unanswered now.
No, they stayed right on it. Once they got that first one, they just pushed the pace of this. Now they get another. But I love watching the way that he handles the puck. Everything's a little fake, a little head shake, a little shoulder move. Now he's in the clear, he's got some room, and it's in the net.
What a play by him to set up that goal, guys. His superstar ability was on full display, and he skates away with the assist.
Gives him a whack, and the officials are going to call this one. And there's the whistle stopping the play.
She's trying to defend to get into a better position, but as she keeps whacking away, the ref's arm goes up for slashing.
Crossman's getting a chance here on the power play, guys. He knows his zone ability can help them generate a good scoring chance. Let's see if they can strike.
Here inside the defensive zone, they get the puck. And they manage to clear it. And now it's over to Bissonnette. Kidd's got it deep in the offensive end. Slides the puck down low. Gatineau's going to play it from the corner. Here's a chance. Stopped by the goaltender. And with that, two periods now in the books. Been a great night of hockey here on EA Sports, and we got the third period coming at you in moments. Been a great night for hockey so far. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Let's drop the puck on this third period. Gatineau's power play is still intact as this period is now underway, and they take possession. Taken by Gates. That's set in deep. Gatineau's got the puck along the boards. Slides it up front. Kisses out of the sin bin. Both sides back to even strength.
Well, the only thing that happened on that power play was the clock rolled along. Very few chances, not much danger.
Long Island's looking to break out of their own end. Sends the pass over. Just wide of the net. Shot attempt completely fails on that. And the traffic neutralizes that threat. Intercepted the pass. Icing is the call. We'll get a reset. Lots of hockey left to be played in this period, and it's a 2-0 hockey game. They take possession as he locks them up off the faceoff. Crossman's moving the puck through his own zone. Lays into the body on the play. Rocks him. Oceanic's got possession here in the neutral zone. Turns it aside with the glove. Stays on top of that for the whistle.
Pretty quickly on top of it to kill the play.
Official signals for the players to get into position, and we're about ready to drop the puck. Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. And no luck on that pass attempt. Almost lost the puck, but hangs on here as play continues. Long Island's gained possession along the boards. Oceanic's got the puck here in the open ice. A shot, and that's blocked. Great use of the stick in the defensive end by Crossman. Keeps hold of the puck. That's a solid hit. Moves it quickly over to Ayers. Here's a blast, and he scores on the rebound. He pops it.
Bad goal, James. It can't go in from behind the goal line.
Long Island's third period deficit suddenly doesn't seem so insurmountable now.
You can almost see the difference in the bench and the body language. They know they've got a chance.
Gatineau's regained possession of the puck. And now he moves it quickly to Crossman. Sends a pass over. Denies him on the play.
Goalies love the butterfly. They know they've got a lot of the net covered, so he slides across. Doesn't worry about this shot.
Good reach to the stick to knock the puck away.
That's close, James. The goaltender ends up beating the shooter to the post. As that looks like it's a goal, but it's shut down.
Past the halfway mark of this period, Oceanic's shown a new energy over these last few minutes. They got one back, but they still need one more in order to tie. And it's a quick pass to Bissonnette. Can't get it to go. Kidney's lugging the puck. Across the line from center.
This is when the coaches find out who's able to be trusted in a tight game. This one is not spread out yet. And this is going to go right down to the end of the wire.
And that's broken up. Kidney's got a hold of the puck behind his own cage. Long Island's across the blue line. Gatineau's got a hold of the puck now. Puck moved back to center, forcing them to regroup. They gain possession here inside the neutral zone. Grabs the puck and looks to make something happen. With the stop. Gatineau's got the puck against the half wall. Grabbed along the boards by Kidd. Good defensive effort to poke it away. Oceanic's got the puck along the wall. Ayers plays it against the boards. Trying to exit the defensive zone. Scores! There's his first in the new colors!
Always good to get on the board. To show that you're able to help your new team, you want to show them that you're ready to play. He's on the board. He'll feel better now.
It's been a pretty big mountain they've had to climb here, and they work all the way back to complete the comeback.
Guys, this is his first goal with this club here, and you know you never forget your first goal. I'm sure his teammates aren't going to forget it either.
Locks them up on the draw as they take possession. Throws one up to Kidd. Stopped with ease.
Save is good. Better yet, that rebound doesn't stay in front of the net. It's over to safety in the corner.
Takes a shot. Locks it down with a stop. I think he got a blocker on that one. Nearing the final minute of regulation. Gatineau's got a hold of the puck. Can't connect. At center ice now. He grabs the puck. Oh, scores! What a finish!
He's got this ability to shoot this heat seeker through traffic. Somehow he finds the lane through so much. And it goes into the net. It's on the board. This is not easy to do against today's goaltenders. They're too big, too quick, really just too good. But he's known for being able to beat goaltenders from distance. He leans into this, and he gets one.
Taken along the wall by Ayers. Oh, smart heads up play to put that one away. Quick feed down low. Heads to the back of the net. Quick feed down low. And he slides it quickly to Andreev. And there's a power play opportunity. Power play unit puts their hard hats on as they go back to work. And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Couldn't find the intended target. Here he is, tries to tuck it in. Gatineau's got control of it now from their own end. Hammers the shot. No room for that one to get through. That's all she wrote from this one.
Well, you always enjoyed a good challenge. What do you make of this one?
Well, if you're going to lay it down, you better be able to back it up. And they did that. That's a solid game for them.
Welcome back to the world of Chell. Remember, you can personalize your visor by adding a colored tint to it and have the look and feel that best suits your aesthetic. It's just another way this community brings their personality to the ice. It's Carlin here, and I just wanted to say how awesome it is to see all of these great players celebrate their goals with some amazing cellies. I'm curious to see if you all will stick with your current celly or mix it up throughout the season.
Beautiful night for hockey. Let's get ready to go. Jake Sabowski and Rick Ferraro ready to bring you all the action. enough hype. Let's do this. Your first period is set to go. The Phoenix have established possession here early in this one as they win the draw. Poked away at center by Riley. Angles it over to Wiley. Throws it in. The Olympique has gained possession. Centering pass in front. And the puck stopper jumps on top of it to get a stoppage in play. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. We're still scoreless. Off the trot, he ties up his opponent. Cross-corner dump in. Quick feed to Crossman. Slides the puck over. Gatineau's trying to make something happen in the offensive zone. Made the stop on the play. Now over to Wiley. To his teammate. Stones him in front.
Excellent chance. They worked the puck into position, and it's a scoring chance. It's turned away.
And puts the body into it. A little bumper car hockey. The Phoenix have it now. And makes the save. And the goalie covers up for the whistle. Center's jammed up and the winger grabs the puck. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. The Olympique have it behind the net. Oh, off the post!
Yeah, close is great, James, but I'd like a goal here. The game still stays scoreless.
Sherbrooke's got the puck. Quick pass to Bissonnette. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Couldn't complete the pass. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. Slides it quickly to Gagnon. Delayed penalty coming up here. Whistle blows, stopping the play.
He came from so far across the rink, and he never slowed up. If he glides the last 10 feet, he's probably okay.
And a man advantage unit comes out to go to work.
You kind of muddle along in a 0-0 game, and now you got a real chance to break that score open. A first power play for you.
The Olympique will play it in their own end. And they clear that puck. Moves the puck into the attacking area. Gatineau's got a hold of it along the wall. Sherbrooke's playing it from the side. Passes right to the front. Oh, so close on that. And they continue to apply pressure here. Moves the puck from off the bank pass. Manages to hang on. Lugs the puck into the offensive zone corner. And that's broken up. I think it's a chance for a breather here as he hangs on and covers the puck up.
Who, for the players or for you?
Well, you know, I won't complain. Power play set to roll on as the centers get ready for the faceoff. Gatineau's won the faceoff deep in their own end. Fantastic save! Maintains possession. Puck cleared from the defensive end. Sherbrooke's power play comes up empty-handed. We're back to even strength on the ice.
Sometimes you go on the ice with the best of intentions, and it goes all wrong right away. That's how I'd characterize that power play.
A chance in front! Oh, and it stays out as it goes off the shaft of the stick on that one.
When he gets the puck, the goalie better be sharp. He's known to create space, get around defenders with his moves, and then shoot the puck quickly.
Gatineau's got it in their own zone. And that pass can't connect. Takes the pass. We got a whistle as the puck goes out of play. friends. Welcome back to EA Sports. Beautiful night for hockey. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Let's get it going tonight. On both blue lines here, and we are about set to drop the puck here at center. There's been a healthy buzz for this one. Now it's time to see if it lives up to the hype. Riley's got it in the defensive end. Sherbrooke's looking to break out. Riley's got the puck in his own zone. Play blown dead. Let's get the call.
Lots of people don't like this rule, James. I do. I mean, the glass is 10 feet high, and he airmails this one up into the crowd.
Kid's got a chance to use his zone ability to help the power play put one up on the board here, guys. Let's see how they do.
Nice job tying up his opponent. Gatineau's got a hold of it along the wall. The Olympique played along the boards. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. Sherbrooke's got the puck shorthanded. Stays with it. Spectacular stop by the goaltender. How did he hang on to that?
It's almost like he's slaloming through the defenders. He can make a move. He's known to create his own room and get to the front of the net. Good save by the goaltender here, though.
And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. Gatineau's got possession of the puck. Handles the bank pass along the boards. Shot on net. Shuts him down. Oh, and another save.
Quick reflexes give him the opportunity to make back-to-back stops.
Pushes it across to Andreev. Takes the feed. And offside, we'll get a reset here. Past the midway mark in this period. We've still got zeros on the board. Great read by the winger to take possession with the two centermen tied up. Gatineau's got the puck in their own end. Moves it to Andreev. Nice zone entry on the left side. Gagneau's stick handling in his own zone. And they'll go the other way with it. The Phoenix have the puck in the open ice. Gatineau's got possession of the puck. Can't connect on the pass. Slides the puck across to Riley. Takes a hit on the play. Sherbrooke's got it along the wall. Nice bank pass off the boards. Here's a short pass to Andreev. That pass doesn't go. Puts it on net. Big time stop there. And the puck stopper hangs on to get a breather here for the team. Here in the later stages of this period, still looking for our first goal. The frozen biscuits dropped and we are back underway here. The Olympiques have it against the wall. Great heads-up play to poke it away at the offensive end. Moves it to Kidd. Great pressure with the stick. From point blank! And he's going after him here.
One guy throws the challenge down. You don't have to take it, especially these days.
Moves the puck. Here's the shot. Oh, what a stop. He tries to tuck it in. Gatineau's got possession here in the offensive zone. Stop that one.
Into the butterfly, slides across to make the save.
And they get the puck out. Winding down the final minute of this opening frame. And that carries off a stick.
Evisceration!
Oh, from here.
He didn't take anything out of that hit. He delivered it really as hard as he could.
Goodness. Can't get it to go. There's the horn. Still 40 more minutes left in regulation time. We'll get to the second period right after this. Both teams had a chance to recharge, and the officials set to drop the puck here on period number two. Still no score in this one. We'll see if period number two finds ourselves a goal. Ray, what's your assessment of the game to this point?
Oh, hey, James, I just woke up. Nobody's had any shots on goal here. The game's scoreless. Chop, chop, boys, get to work.
Shesterkin's going to give everyone a chance to breathe and hang on to the puck. We're still in the early stages of this period. Still scoreless in this one. And as the puck is dropped, they win the draw here inside the defensive zone. And he uses his reach to disrupt the play. Gains the zone on the left wing. Oh, wow! That had some hot sauce on that collision.
Did it ever, James. I mean, you could see he was raring to get a hit in to try and change a little bit of the momentum, and the shoulder went into the player. That's a solid, clean hit.
Sherbrooke's got the puck along the boards. And now it's grabbed by Riley. Whacks it into the offensive zone. Gatineau's got the puck. Directed over to Kidd. Here's the pass. Big save in front.
That is a good save, James, but usually when he gets the puck in that position, it's money. This time, turned away.
Takes the feed. Scores! The defender put it into his own net.
His puck on a string zone ability was key to setting up that goal, guys. He stick-handled his way to the open ice and picked up a great assist.
Sherbrooke's won the draw, and they take possession here in the open ice. Glove save by the goalie. McDonald's going to hang on to that one for a whistle.
Quickly on top of that, James, he needed a cover there.
Still a lot of time left in the period as we approach the midway mark. We got a 1-0 game to this point. Sherbrooke's got it in the defensive zone. Receives the pass. Inside the offensive zone, takes the pass from along the boards. Gatineau's looking to break out of their own end. And a nice poke check inside the neutral zone. And that's knocked aside with the stick by Kidd. Moves it quickly over to Riley. Nice pass. Puts it in deep. Gatineau's got a hold of it against the wall. And they turn it over in the neutral zone. And makes the routine save.
Sliding across in the butterfly covers most of the bottom of the net.
Off the outside of the iron!
Gatineau's really grinding on this game. They want to get this game back to even, but that shot off the post won't help them.
And he slides it quickly to Crossman. Errant pass, and they can't connect. And here at center, that's intercepted. And now he angles it across to Andreev. Oh, he stops him with a glove. Great reflexes there. More than half the frame has been played here. We've got a 1-0 hockey game thus far. Gatineau's won the draw and they'll go to work. And a strong effort on that play.
McDonald's probably the one reason that this game is the way it is. His save percentage has been outstanding.
Takes a slap shot from the point. Gets down to block it. Great poke check on the reach. Scoops up the puck now. Gatineau's gained possession along the boards. We got a penalty coming up here on the play. There's the whistle, and here's the call.
There are times you can see that interference penalty, James, coming from a mile away. That one was pretty obvious.
Here's a first look at the power play.
First chance of the night for the power play. The guys are pretty excited to get out there and see if they can get on the board.
Straight up the middle. Here they come. Steps inside the line. They go on the attack from the left side. Looking to clear the defensive zone. And they do just that.
I thought they did a pretty good job there, James. That's a time you can get yourself running around in the zone. They didn't get there.
Gatineau's got the puck in the defensive end. And that's a great heads-up play in the offensive zone. Goaltender covers up and will get a face-off. Another face-off looming here on this power play. The Olympique win the draw. Trying to clear, and they get it down.
Yeah, good communication. They talk to each other. They're in the right spot. They just clear it down the ice.
How did he stop that one?
Riley's hard to play against because he'll wear you down with his big hits, guys. That's his truculent zone ability, and it's how he stays so effective without the puck.
Crossman's ready to go.
And the puck clears the zone. Both teams are now back to even strength as the power play has expired.
And nobody's going to be very happy about that one, James. No real chances generated. No momentum game. Just a couple of minutes roll off the clock.
Gets the tip. He scores! They tied it up!
Brand new game. All that work has gone behind this. And we're back to even, Steven. That change of direction's tough for the goalie to follow. It's past him before he can react.
The Olympique has got new life on the bench. You can see it as they even things up in the late stages of the second.
Where I'm standing, it's pretty easy to tell that they've just scored. Really a lot of excitement. Now the game is tied as we have just a few minutes left in this middle frame.
He scores! Breaks the deadlock!
Really good play at the net. And now somebody's got a lead, and we'll see if they can increase it. You got to get into the middle of the ice to score. He's in the low slot, and he whips the backhander past the goalie.
Here in the late goings of the period, Gatineau's got a one-goal lead. Now a quick pass to Andreev. Reads the pass perfectly and picks it off. Here's a blast! Scores! Bar down for the goal!
It's a terrific delivery. He beats a goaltender up high. Gets a lucky break, though. It hits the crossbar and bounces into the net.
The Phoenix have even things up at a critical time, Razor.
Yeah, you get late into the second period. You want to put yourselves in as good a position as possible. They tie the game up. Real nice job to get themselves back level.
Turns it over. They've got numbers here. That's kicked away with the pad by McDonald. Sherbrooke's got a hold of the puck now. And there's the horn, bringing the second period to an end. All right, they say three is the magic number. Period number three is coming up next. Both teams seem fresh after that second intermission. We're ready to drop the puck on period number three. It's been a fun one so far, all tied up as we are now underway here in the third period. Quick pass across to Kidd. Oh, what a big hit on the play.
Outstanding play. Closed the lane off, finished him hard.
Sends it down low. Moves the puck more to the middle. Scooped up along the wall by Kidd. Sherbrooke's got the puck here in the open ice. And that's offside, stopping the play. Lots of time left in this period. We are all tied up in this one. Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. Handles the pass at center. Gadneau's got the puck along the wall. From center, they get into the attacking area. And a stick in the lane ends that threat. Handles the puck. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Great reach with the poke check. The Phoenix have gained control of the puck along the wall. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Quick feed to Kidd. Chance on the deflection. That's a beautiful pad save by the goalie there.
We see goaltenders in this butterfly practicing it every day. Positioning, keeping their arms tight, making sure that they stay in the center of the puck.
Oh, that was violent.
Yeah, he hit him so hard, the people sitting right on the glass are going to sit up straight. They're scared, too.
And we'll reset things after that icing. We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. You can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. Puck is dropped and we are back underway.
That win will help them get organized defensively.
Gadneau's got it in their own zone. Centering pass! And we got a leader as he tucks it into the net!
These teams are jammed together. That goal might open it up. That's a bullseye. He gets the puck back close to the net. He never misses. What a quick shot.
As we saw in that last play, guys, he's so accurate from point-blank range. His close-quarter superstar ability helped him bury it from in tight.
Off a stick and they can't connect. Moves behind the net. Shot.
Whoa.
He scores!
Little tweak to the crowd here on the road as he gets it third. An outstanding game so far. He didn't have much room up over the glove, but as soon as the goalie dropped into the butterfly, there was enough for him to put it into the top bin.
Centers are set, face-off ready to resume play. Gadneau's won the draw in the neutral zone. And a poke check knocks the puck away. That pass goes a little sideways. Poked away and forces the turnover at center. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Sherbrooke's on the attack. Gets in front of it.
Scores!
They came, they saw, they took advantage of the rebound and score.
This is what creative offense looks like, James. Dangling play around the defender. He's got everybody frozen, ends up with an assist as this puck ends up in the back of the net.
The Phoenix have to find one more goal here, but they've made it closer.
I like the way they've played this period, and now only down one. They don't have to go crazy with the chances to take to get the tying goal.
Right out front, can't connect. Wiley's swooping in on the attack. right in front of the net. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. Moves the puck along the half wall. And that's knocked away by Wiley. Sherbrooke's got a hold of the puck. Wiley's gaining momentum. Unloads it! That's off a stick. Quick pass to Andreoff. The Olympique will play it from the defensive zone. Bissonnette's got the puck now in his own end. Gatineau's got it in their own zone. Looking to get it out. And that one's blocked. It stays in. And that's off a stick. And they'll be forced to tag up after that missed pass. He's got a step, and they score! And we've seen this sacked before, Racer.
You get in that close, and he's got the puck. Good night. He doesn't miss from there. Great example here of close-quarter zone ability, James. In tight, you have to still deliver that puck accurately. It's done to perfection.
While the centers are jammed up, nice job by the winger to steal the puck. Gaining steam here on the attack. Sends the pass over. Gatineau's got control of it now from their own end. Big hit on the play.
He's not missed many of these. Every time he gets the puck, they seem to target him, and he's not been able to elude anybody.
Getting into the later stages of this period, the Olympiques now lead by two. Sherbrooke's got possession here in their own end. Approaching the final minute of regulation. There's the whistle icing the call. And we're moments away from getting back underway here with the puck drop. Sherbrooke's won the draw. Here's a short pass on fire.
Sometimes it's just your night. You shoot the puck, it goes in the net. He's had an unbelievable evening. I love this, James. I mean, this is kind of what I did. You get into close quarters here, that puck's got to go quick into the net.
One of the reasons I loved that goal was because he was able to use his superstar ability to his advantage, guys. And here on this one, he does not miss.
Sherbrooke's got a hold of it along the wall. Gatineau's got the puck in their own end. Sends it quickly to Crossman. Nice zone entry from the left. The Olympique is carried along the wall. And no luck on that pass attempt. Feeds the puck to Wiley. Picks off the pass. Look out, here they come on the attack. Nice poke check. Sends a pass over. Big stop by the goaltender right in front.
Oh, he's got to feel like he got robbed. I mean, he's money in there. In tight, that's his spot.
Some pushing and shoving here, heating up.
Yeah, the few words lead to a little bit more, it looks like. Oh, that's going to be a penalty. They're going to have to call that.
Let's get the call.
Right now, if you're sitting on that bench, the only thing you're frustrated about is the whistle's going to blow and you've got to start and stop again. You want to go home now.
Bissonnette's won the draw here in the offensive zone. He was totally locked in on that play. That's it. There's the final horn to close this one up. Ray, was kind of a bold challenge, but they were ready for it, I guess.
Well, we wondered if they were, and the way that they played this game, it was pretty clear they were ready for this.